everybody. Welcome to the Fiber Nerd Podcast. My name is Allison Barnes, and I am the indie dyer behind Allison Barnes Yarn. I live in Edmonton, Alberta, Canada, with my husband, my son, and my three cats. Today is Monday, February 5th, and I am sitting in my office, also known as the yarn room or studio. It gets called a number of different things. So look, no cat today. She's sleeping somewhere in the house, which is just fine with me. So I thought I would come on here and talk to you a little bit about some knitting, some sewing, some dyeing yarn, and a little bit about a fiber festival that's coming up in Edmonton in May. So I guess I will start off with thanking viewers for coming back and welcoming any new viewers for checking out my podcast. I do this podcast about once a week just to try to connect with people who like knitting and who like hand-dyed yarn and any other kinds of crafty things that you like to do. I like to do a lot of crafty things too. So, I guess I will talk to you a little bit about my knitting, which isn't even in this room because it's in a timeout. I actually worked on my sister's shawl mystery knit along this week. I didn't do as much knitting as I normally would get done because we did have a celebrate my son's birthday. He's 8 years old, and that was on last Tuesday. So, I'm on the part of my sister's shawl where you do lace. It's called Lacy Zags, and this is the second section of lace. And the first time I did the lace, I had no problems at all. But for some reason, on Saturday night, it was my third evening working on the lace, and I had gotten about halfway through the lace when I noticed that I had dropped a stitch. And I can read my knitting if it's very basic knitting, just garter or stockinette. I can tell when I've done certain stitches, but the lace, no, I can't. I cannot fix lace. I tried figuring out where this stitch was supposed to go. I tried to loop it through a bunch of loops and bring it back up to the needle, and I thought, okay, that's not bad. This looks a little wonky here, so I'm gonna knit these three together because the lace kind of makes these diamond shapes. And so I'm like, okay, that's actually not too bad. So I decided to keep knitting, and I looked down, and even further back I had dropped another stitch or two. And so I'm like, okay, should I try and fix this, or should I just frog it back? Because I tried to count how many stitches I actually had on the needles, and even by pulling up the two stitches that were dropped, I was going to be one short, and I just didn't know where I went wrong. And because the lace is patterned in diamonds, I didn't want to screw up the shape of the lace. It has a very specific shape. You can't really fudge it. So I frogged back about, I don't know, 4 inches of lace. And yeah, so that's in a timeout. I may work on it tonight, but chances are slim. I'm still not really feeling like picking that back up yet. So I'm still on clue 4, and this lace is the last bit of clue 4 before I can move on to clue 5. So I am definitely not going to be done the MCAL in time, but that's fine. I don't want to stress about my knitting. I want to enjoy my knitting, and if I need to put it down for a little while, that's what I'm going to do. So what else did I knit on? Well, I think last week I showed you my finished sock and that I had started this wee little cuff of the next sock. Well, I only got a little bit further. I'm almost done the cuff. I wanted a nice long cuff, like about 2 inches. That's something that I'm trying on this pair of socks. And so I'm not going to show you that sock again because it really doesn't look any different. But I do have a new sock that I cast on that I am ready to share with you. It is in a new colorway, and I'm just going to grab the color actually in the skein. And I have to remember what I called this because I don't remember. What did I call this one? I don't have a label on my yarn. This is the new color. It is gray and mint green with dark gray speckles. And I dyed it so that it would be in a similar, it would have, be dyed in a similar fashion to my Whisper colorway, which is a light pink instead of this mint green. And what did I name it? I'm gonna have to look that up. Okay, so I had to look up the name because I actually have four new colorways that are dyed similarly to Whisper, but I'm just gonna share the one new one with you today. So the name of this new one is called Sigh. So we have Whisper and Sigh. This is that I'm using like quiet names to name these because they're all softly colored, subtly speckled, and I decided that I was going to knit the prong sock. It is a pattern by Woolfield Studio, and I don't actually have the pattern with me, and this is the start of my cuff. I'm going to pull it back here so you can see a little bit better. It's very subtle. And the prong sock pattern is, it has a really pretty cable texture down the front of the sock. And I'm not a huge fan of cabling, but this is apparently very easy. And I'm hoping that I'm not too slow at it because I would love to have one sock finished for my next market as a display piece for showing off this new color. So I'm not going to share the other colors today because I have sent the other three colors out to a couple designers for some collaborations, and one of them will be coming out soon, and the other one she just received her color, so it may be a little while before she gets around to designing with that one. But all of the colors, I will definitely show all of the colors before my next market, which is March 10th and 11th at the curated market in Edmonton at the Prince of Wales Armories, and I plan on having a whole bunch of these new colors just in time for that and for spring. So that is the start of my itty bitty sock, and I'm actually using some of my 9-inch circular needles that I carry in my shop. These are the, what are they called again? I can't remember. I have a package somewhere. They are Knitter's Pride Dreams, and they are a wooden needle, and I wasn't sure if I would like the wooden needle because I like my steel sharps, my Hiya sharps a lot, and I've also used Chiagu 9-inch circulars, but I've never used the wooden 9-inch circulars, and I would say the cast-on and the first, not the cast-on, but maybe the first two rows were just a little sticky for me, but now I've got my rhythm, and the yarn slides very nicely across the wooden part of the needle. It's actually a very slick wood, and so I'm not sure, maybe just my tension was a little tight when I first started the sock, but I will update you as I progress on this pattern, and I will put a link to the pattern in the down bar so you can actually see what it looks like. If I can figure out how to insert a picture, I will do that so that you can see what this beautiful cabled sock actually looks like. That is going to be it for the knitting segment of this episode, because I have no other progress to show with you because of my goof up and dropping stitches on the My Sister shawl. But I guess I would love to show you this bag. I showed it maybe on the first or second episode. It is this cute drawstring bag from the Kitchen Sink Shop. And one of the cats just woke up. And it is the cutest drawstring bag. It has this denim bottom and birds on a bird print on the top and a different bird print on the inside. And you know I love birds, so I started using this for this prong sock, and I love it. I love closing it, and it's just so pretty, and I can shove this in my purse, and I always have my project to take on the go with me. So I want to see if maybe the cat wants to come in here, because I don't think you guys have seen Kennedy before, and she's not a vocal cat, but she's actually making little cute little noises. She must like the new toy I bought for her today. So, speaking of sewing, guess how much sewing I got done in the last week? Zero. The last time I showed you a pair of pants that I made for my son, I had hoped to sew together a cardigan this weekend, but then I ended up spending a lot of my free time working on the Fiber Frolic. The Edmonton Fiber Frolic is a fiber festival, kind of a one-day marketplace for hand-dyed yarn, roving, spinning, weaving, that kind of thing. Anything for the knitter or fiber artist. We have a one-day marketplace. This will be our second year. Myself and Jessica Coleman from Haven Fiber Arts host this event in Edmonton. And it is on May 26, 2018 at the Terwilliger Community Church. And oh my goodness, she's actually meowing.
Hi!
I think she really likes the new toy. It's this weird little thing. It looks like a fish. And I think it has catnip in it. I've never heard her meow before. So the Edmonton Fiber Frolic, I will put the information in the down bar for you so that you can book it in your calendars. There will be a small entry fee, and we have about 40 vendors booked, which is almost double of last year. And I will be vending, Jessica will be vending, and we have a whole bunch of fiber artists from Alberta. And I don't know if you can hear her, but she's starting to find her voice.
Hi! 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 What are you doing?
So cute.
Come here. Hi. Hi. Come here. Come here. Come on.
So this is Kennedy. This is Kennedy.
Hi.
She's got the tiniest, squeakiest meow. She never meows. It was so funny.
Okay, bye. Thanks for coming.
So cute. I'm sorry, I'm so distracted. She's so adorable. So the Edmonton Fiber Frolic. Yes, we have a website. We have a newsletter. You can sign up for the newsletter from our website, and it's edmontonfiberfrolic.com. Again, the information is in the down bar for you. And so what I would like to do, because of I didn't get the sewing done, I would like to show you the pieces that are already cut out for my cardigan, because I cut them out like 2 weeks or more ago. They've just been waiting for me to sew them together. So maybe this weekend I might actually get to sew them together. So I'm going to pause the video and go and grab the fabric. Cats are cute. I'm just drinking some coffee today. It's in the afternoon. I did my errands this morning, so now I get to podcast and get it uploaded to you guys. But I wanted to show you the pieces of the cardigan that I'm sewing together soon. Hopefully soon. This is the front, one side of the front, like this. It's just a really lightweight sweater knit and kind of a heather dark gray. And this, there's one side of the front, and this is the other side of the front. And then the, what's this one? The back. This is the back. I didn't have enough of all of the fabric to make one solid color because I bought like end of the bolt pieces. So this is the back. This is another sweater knit. It has a really fun texture and pattern on it. So this will be the back piece. And it's gonna come down past my bum because I wanted a longer one. The style of the cardigan is, it's called a Grandpa Cardi. And it's another Patterns for Pirates pattern. I really enjoy sewing them up. This is a sleeve. So the sleeves will be this gray. So I guess we'll see what it looks like when it's done. And then it has a like a placket or whatever it's called that goes from the bottom around the neck and then back down to the front. And that'll be in this same dark gray. And then I have little patch pockets that are this. So this color will be a patch pocket on the bottom of the front pieces. So yeah, so I hope I can find time to get that sewn together because I would love to be able to wear it. It has been so cold here lately, and that's why I'm wearing my flax sweater, because it's needed. It has been very chilly here. Not only has it been very chilly here, we have gotten a lot of snow in the last week. So much snow. Probably our first big dump of snow was probably 6 to 8 inches. Then we got another big dump of snow that was probably another 4 to 6 inches. And we are running out of room to shovel the snow off of our driveway. The piles of snow on either side of the driveway are as tall as my son. Who's 8, who's just over 4 feet tall. And he can't believe it. He's never seen snow like that. We used to get snow like that when I was a kid. I remember having snow like it is outside right now. This is how a real Alberta winter should be, and we haven't had snow like this in so long. So fingers crossed that this is going to be a good amount of moisture for the farmers this year, as long as it doesn't melt too early, because then it'll just run off and not seep into the ground. So that's going to be my Grandpa Cardi. And if you're interested in Patterns for Pirates, I will link that down below as well. Hi, Kennedy. Oh, so the next part of the podcast, I will update you on what's coming into the shop this week on Wednesday. Shop update is Wednesday, February 7th, and that will be at 5 p.m. Mountain Standard Time. I'm just looking at the cat down below. So I need to go and grab those yarns because they are on the drying racks downstairs. Okay, I have a pile of yarn, and this isn't all of it. It's all of the colors, but it's not all of the yarn. I'm going to not skein them before I show them to you because there's just too many, and I'm just going to show you the colors up close to the camera. So if you might recognize this color, this is Prairie Rain, and I dyed some more on my basic sock base. So I'll have some of this going into the shop update on Wednesday. And I also dyed Prairie Rain on my sparkle sock base. So I don't know if you can see the sparkles, I thought it would be really fun to have some on Sparkle Sock. So there will be some of that. I have dyed some more Attacked by Tiny Dragons. This is one of my Dawn Cherry inspired colorways from my Cherry Picked line. I'll have three skeins of this on Basic Sock. And this is a kind of a newer color. It's called London Fog. It is a very pale purplish gray. And this was one of the semi-solids that went with my bonus Yarn of the Month Club at the end of December. So I thought it was really, really pretty. I'm going to stick it right here because I think that shows off the color best. It's a very, very pale lavender gray. And yes, it is called London Fog. So I will have some London Fog on Basic Sock. On Sparkle Sock. And on Classic DK. I think that would make a really pretty sweater. And I think that it might make really great hair because I'm thinking of going purple. Stay tuned for that. My hair appointment is towards the end of February. Okay. I will have some hand spun thick and thin yarn in the color Mojito. So there is that Mojito on Basic Sock already in the shop. So there is the hand-spun thick and thin version of it. I will have some shag carpet on DK. The skeins are a little messy, but I will tidy them up and photograph them for the shop update. Do you know why these skeins get a little bit messy? Because when you do a semi-solid color in the dye pot, you have to stir it a lot to make sure that the color penetrates as evenly as you can get. And so lots of stirring means lots of strands. They are not tangled, they just become untidy. And they can be tidied up by combing, by like stretching and snapping, or by reskeining. It does not affect your yarn whatsoever. You may find if you're winding it into a ball off of a swift that the strands may be tucked underneath each other and it may make it more difficult to wind a ball, but they are not tangled because they are still tied. They still have their ties around them, keeping them tangle free. It just doesn't look as tidy as, say, as a color that I don't dye with lots of stirring, such as this one. This skein is much tidier, and this skein is called Mixed Tape. So Mixed Tape is one of the three colors in my three skein sets called Like Totally, because of the neon colors. So it's neon yellow, neon pink, and dark blue speckles. The other colors in the three skein set are, now I don't remember which one's which. This is the neon pink, and this is the neon yellow. Whoa, that is so bright. But one of the colors is called Scrunchy, and the other one's called Leg Warmers, and I don't remember which one is which. I have it written down somewhere. And the three colors together look like this. And I have seen at least one My Sister shawl being knit out of that set. So I will have one set available in the shop this week because I had a request for a pre-order for one set and I like to dye in twos. So there will be one set of it available in the shop this week. The other three skein set that I will have available in the shop is my Vintage Family Room set, and that includes a skein of shag carpet, a skein of Velvet Chesterfield, and a skein of Etched Mirror Wall. And this is one of my very favorite colors. And this set is the one I'm using to knit my own sister shawl Again, you can see the difference between a skein that is laying out to dye is much tidier than a skein that is stirred and stirred and stirred in the pot. Okay? Again, they are not tangled. They're just a little bit unkempt. So I will have one set of these skeins in the shop on Wednesday. Now I wanted to show you, I did dye a couple of Dirty Cowboy on DK, a couple extra, and the DK, this Dirty Cowboy was on the drying rack next to the shag carpet, and I just wanted to show you how pretty they look together. Don't those colors look gorgeous together? I never would have put them together except that they ended up side by side on the drying rack. And I thought they were very, very pretty. So I just had to show you. And so there's one more color going in the shop, and it is Spruce Tree. It is my very, very dark green. And I already have it on DK and Worsted Weight in the shop, but I ran out of sock. So I dyed more sock because I know some of you really like this color. It's great for shawls, it's great for socks. And I've seen it together with What a Peach in a shawl. And they are just so pretty together. So I will have quite a bit of Spruce Tree in the shop. And it looks just like a spruce tree. It's a very, very, very dark tealy, greenish, bluish color. So I think all I have left to show you is some merino roving or comb top. It's actually called comb top, but a lot of people refer to it as roving. I did dye a bunch of semi-solids for this week's shop update. I had a request for some solids. There is a lady in Edmonton who does some felting, needle felting, I believe, and she was in need of some new colors. So I did dye some of those colors, as well as some other colors. I like to test out new dyes on roving. I like taking a small sample of the roving and keeping that for and anytime I need color inspiration. So I'm going to go and grab the roving or comb top and show you the different colors that will be in the shop this week. So recently I had purchased a bunch of colors, a bunch of dyes from Dharma Trading Company, and along with restocking some of my regular colors, I decided to splurge and buy a bunch of new colors, and I do like to test those on roving. So one of those new colors is this one, and it's called Delphinium, and I dye these in my crock pot, and so it is a semi-solid color. I do not stir these. This is 100% merino. I put it in the crock pot with like lukewarm water with the dye, citric acid, and then I put the pre-wetted roving in, and then I kind of gently massage it and turn it around and try and get the dye to cover all the areas of the roving. And then I set my crock pot on high for 2 hours and I let that heat set in the crock pot. So that is how I get these semi-solid colors. So that is Delphinium. This is another new one called Soft Tan. It's really pretty. I had no idea what it would turn out like because quite often dyes change color when they're heated. And this one started out kind of pinky red, but it is so pretty. I would say that's a soft tan. Very, very pretty. This one, I believe, is Teddy Bear Brown, but I have another one that is very similar called Chocolate Brown, and so I didn't bring it upstairs. And you can see how brown will break apart into its component colors. So this one has some reddish colors and some purplish colors, and of course, it's mainly brown all over, but you do get the color breaking on the roving, like right there. Yeah, so this one I think I said it was teddy bear brown. Now this one is supposed to be a very dark brown called espresso bean, but it came out very purple and there are blue places in it. And honestly, I think that this might be the only brown section. So I'm curious to see what it actually looks like on superwash yarn. This is just non-superwash merino. It's still very pretty. I'm sure it will spin up lovely. It just wasn't what I was expecting. This next one, I can't remember what this one is called. Forest green, I think. And to me, forest green should be maybe something more like this. So this is another one of those colors that I would be anxious to see what it looks like on superwash yarn, where I can kind of control the color a little bit better. So it's still very pretty. It will spin up very, very pretty. It has a lot of light and dark areas, so it will give a lot of tonal variation when you spin with this or felting. You can pick, say you need a darker green, so you might pick from here. You need a lighter green, you might pick from here for your felting projects. This one is just regular brown. This is not a Dharma color. This is a jacquard color, jacquard brown. And it turned out really well. This is a nice light to medium brown. I'm tangled up here. A nice light to medium brown. It did break in a few places. You can see where it kind of went purplish. And brown often does that. Especially if you speckle with brown. With this brown, it can go purplish and reddish. And greenish. That's a very, very pretty brown. It kind of matches my hair. I like that. That's a nice brown. And then lastly, I have this a pale orange or apricot color. I was trying to get a flesh tone. It definitely doesn't match my flesh tone. And I have about 3 different versions of this, trying to get the right combination of just trying to get the right color. And so there will be a few that look kind of like this in the shop as well. They might actually look really pretty spun together. As you pull the roving apart and spin it, it does tend to go a little lighter. So it might make a good flesh tone. I'm just super pale and it doesn't work for me, for my flesh tone. So that's it for roving. Again, there's another brown and there's a few more of those apricot-y, orangey colors, and I have lots more dyes to test out on roving, so those will be getting dyed up hopefully this week. And I'm gonna say that that's it for shop update. And other than that, do I have anything exciting to talk about in my life? This week's very busy. It is appointment heavy for me. Today, of course, was my errand day. Tomorrow morning, I have a massage. I go for a massage once a month. It really helps with, especially my hands. And I hold a lot of tension into my jaw and my hips. So I find that really helps me to go for a regular massage. Then I have a doctor's appointment in the afternoon. On Wednesday morning I have yoga. So Wednesday afternoon I might do a little bit of dyeing, some more roving, and then I have some colors to test out. I don't know if you can see in this bag up here are some project bags that I'm going to be turning into sock bag and sock yarn kits. So I'll probably show those off maybe next week, and actually maybe I'll grab the bags and I'll just show you what the bags look like so you can get an idea of maybe what's coming up. So this week I hope to get to dyeing some sock sets. and I'm going to be using these bags as inspiration. These are all bags from Andrea's Handspuns, my friend Andrea. She lives in Edmonton, and she has two styles of bags. And this is a sock knot bag, and you could slip this through here and then carry it like this, and it kind of keeps it closed. You can also slip it over your arm. And if you like to walk and knit, you can do that. It's just a perfect size for one skein, so that's why it's great for a sock. And so this one is a bunch of different product, old-fashioned product labels. And so I'm going to be pulling my color inspiration from the fabric. What else do we have? Another a knot bag. This one is some blues, and there's a little bit of red in there too. There's her label there, Andrea's Handspuns. Here is another knot bag. This one's really pretty, and it has a faux leather bottom. That's fun. It's kind of a shiny gray with a tree and some deer, maybe, on it. It's pretty. And I think this is the last knot bag, and it is another like old-fashioned product label type fabric. So that's really cute. Okay, the next style of bags are a drawstring sock bag. She calls them, what does she call them? Yarn Party sock bags. So they're kind of like I have the Yarn Party bag, and it's that big one with four dividers in the bottom and pockets galore, and it's a drawstring top. Well, she designed a sock bag with the drawstring top. So, and this is actually the same fabric that my Yarn Party bag is made out of. Birds, of course. Crazy birds. I love it. Crazy birds. And it has a really pretty linen bottom. And the inside is white, so you can easily find something that you drop in the bottom of your bag. So these are also going to be color inspiration for sock sets. So it's going to be a bag and yarn. I'm planning on doing a full-size skein and a mini skein to match, so that you can make socks and they'll match your bag. So this is the first one. There's a coffee one. There is another, like an old label, old-fashioned product bag with more of that really pretty, this is a brown linen. And lastly, I have this fun kind of floral with the gray linen on the bottom. All of these bags have the white interior and the drawstring top. So that's what I'm doing this week. Hopefully I have time for that. Like I said, it's an appointment heavy week. Thursday morning, my son has his yearly checkup. And then Thursday afternoon, I need to go, hopefully, to my local yarn store, the Fiber Nook, and buy some yarn for a sweater for my dad. He knows how much I've been really getting into knitting lately, and back in the fall, he mentioned how he would really like a knit sweater, one with a zipper, like a cardigan, a zip-up cardigan. And so now I kind of got the bug, and I started looking at patterns, and I decided, well, I had two patterns in mind, and he saw one of the ones that my friend suggested, and it's the Chicane Sweater by Brooklyn Tweed. And I will link that pattern below, and if I can, like I said, if I can figure out how to insert a picture, I will put it in here. So you can see what it looks like. It's it looks like a basic men's sweater, but it has a really cool detail on the sleeve here, and it has ribbing on the bottom part of the arm, like a long ribbing part on the bottom, and this textured detail here, with a zip up and just a crew collar, nothing too fussy. And so I bought the pattern, and it calls for worsted weight, but I don't plan on using the recommended yarn. I don't feel like I want to use the recommended yarn, so I'm going to go shop at the Fiber Nook and see what they have there in a color that my dad would like and in a yarn that I would like to knit. So, and then Friday, my son has a PD day, so we're probably just going to do some things around the house. It might snow again this week, so we might have more shoveling to do, and if it's not too cold, we may get to go sledding. It's been too cold to go sledding, even though we've had a ton of snow. So that's it, I guess. Thank you guys for watching and for leaving me your comments, giving me thumbs up, subscribing to the video. As always, if you have questions, you can leave them below. You can email me at allisonbarnescollection@gmail.com. You can check out my website at allisonbarnesyarn.com. And I hope you guys have a great week. I plan to be here next Tuesday, so I will see you then. Bye-bye.